We're going to read excerpt number 7. So, how, said Abraham, will they receive the light when they have no vessels, no kelim, called a need? At that time, the Creator told him, know for certain that your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs. In other words, the people of Israel will be in an eretz, in a land, meaning a ratzon, a desire, that does not belong to the people of Israel. Rather, they will be under the governance of the will to receive, which belongs to Pharaoh, king of Egypt. They will be tormented, meaning that the people of Israel will suffer because they are unable to work in order to bestow, which would bring them adhesion, dvekut with the Creator. At that time, they will need the Creator's help, as it is written, and their cry rose up to God from the work, and God heard their groaning, and God remembered His covenant with Abraham. Number 8. What do we see in the Creator's reply to Abraham's question, by what would I know, etc., that by being in a land that is not theirs, meaning in exile, Abraham could be certain that they would inherit the land? He said that since there is no light without a kli, without a vessel, meaning no filling without a lack, and Abraham said to the Creator that he did not see that they would need such great lights called the land of Israel, the Creator told him that by being in exile and by asking the Creator to deliver them from exile, how will He deliver them? No, only with great lights, since the light in it reforms him. Thus, then they will have the need for the great lights.
9. We can interpret what Abraham, the patriarch, asked of the Creator. How will I know that I will inherit it? For how will they be able to accept the burden of faith, since it is against reason? And who can go against reason? Thus, how will they come to be granted the light of faith, since perfection depends on this alone? The Creator answered him about this, know for certain, etc., that they will be in exile. This means that He prepared a klipa, a shell, which is the evil inclination, an evil person, Pharaoh, king of Egypt. The letters of the word Pharaoh are like the letters of the word Orif, back of the neck. As Dari wrote in Sha'ar Kavanah for Pesach, that Pharaoh is considered the Orif, the narrow in the sea. He would suck out the abundance that comes down to the lower ones with his question, who is the Lord that I should obey His voice? By this very question, they are in the hands of the klipot, of the shells. We're in 10.
10, good.
When a person should work for the sake of the Creator, which is to him above reason, a person has no regard for this, since the body resists working for no reward. Therefore, when we say to the body that we must work only in order to bestow upon the Creator, the body says that this is far from the mind, and it is not worth straining for such. Then the person sees that he cannot overcome the body. As Baal HaSulam explained, the fact that it is not within man's power to emerge from the control of the will to receive for himself, the Creator did this on purpose, so that by this, a person will acquire a need for the Creator's help. For otherwise, he is lost. Hence, when a person asks the Creator to help him, by this he receives help from above. This is the light of the Torah, which reforms him. As said in the Zohar, that by this he receives vessels and the need to attain the non-chai of neshama. This was the Creator's answers to Abraham's question, how will I know that I will inherit it?
Okay.
Yes. Excerpt 11. A person must begin the war so as to have kelim and the need for salvation and the help of the Creator. As was said, if the Creator did not help him, he would not overcome it. It follows that he did not give man the ability to win the war on, since through the war, one obtains the vessels and need for the abundance. Hence, we need both to enter the war so as to obtain kelim, vessels, and the help that is required, that specifically the Creator will help him, since through the help, he obtains the inheritance of the land that the Creator promised to Abraham. 12. And a certain man found him, and behold, he was wandering in the field. And the man asked him, saying, "What are you seeking?" And he said, "I seek my brothers. Tell me, I pray you, where they are feeding the flock." A man wandering in the field refers to a place from which the crop of the field to sustain the world should spring. And the works of the field are plowing, sowing, and reaping. It is said about that, "They that sow in tears shall reap in joy." And this is called a field which the Lord has blessed. Baal HaTorim explained that a person wandering in the field refers to one who strays from the path of reason, who does not know the real way, which leads to the place he should reach, as in an ass wandering in the field. And he comes to a state where he thinks that he will never achieve the goal he should achieve. And the man asked him, saying, "What are you seeking?" Meaning, "How can I help you?" And he said, "I seek my brethren." By being together with my brothers, that is, by being in a group where there is love of friends, I will be able to mount the trail that leads to the house of God. This trail is called a path of bestowal. And this way is against our nature. To be able to achieve it, there is no other way but love of friends, by which everyone can help his friend. And the man said, "They are departed hence." And Rashi interpreted that they had departed themselves from the brotherhood, meaning they do not want to bond with you. This, in the end, caused Israel exile in Egypt. And to be redeemed from Egypt, we must take it upon ourselves to enter a group that wants to be in love of friends. And by that, we will be rewarded with the exodus from Egypt and the reception of the Torah.